It's locked. I'm not getting in this way.
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave. Now. You don't know how dangerous this is.
What's wrong with you? You can't keep sneaking after me.
I'm here to help you, Mira. You know that. I'm not here for my own pleasure. It's my job.
Oh, fine. Then do your job. And find me a way through this door.
Mira, I would be here anyway, but I can't afford not to help you.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly round here.
No, it's not worth your life.
Thank you for saying that. I guess I better not die then. Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place. Don't you know the imp has murdered the king?
I'm sorry. I'm leaving, right now.
Not so fast. I'm not going to ask you again. Oi! Whoever's in there, I command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You, don't move.
Tom, it's me! Hurry!
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose. Almost lost my footing. And then, the jump to the terrace.
Thank you, Tom. I could never have done this without you. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree!
Well, go on! That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
He said that it would be on his desk. It's the bill for the wedding. This is more money than I could spend in a lifetime. Nothing. Just a letter from Tywin Lannister. Oh, another bloody letter! Tyrion's strongbox! Oh, it must be in here.
I think the Lannister guard is back.
No, it's the other one.
Damn it! Hide! I find a way to distract them.
Stuck.
I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them.
And after? Now that we've got the imp's keys, we can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
You did it. How?
I lit a tapestry on fire, down the hall. I'll put you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. It has to be. No.
Just hurry!
Oh.
Come on!
It worked! Is this? Oh, thank the gods! Oh, I found it!
Finally! Let's go!
I catch the bastard who...
Oh, wring their bloody neck!
We're not far now. Gwyn Whitehill may already be there.
What is this? Our ironwood trees. It's the Whitehills. You see what they've done? This track was hundreds of years old. And they reduced it to nothing.
Before this is done, we'll make them pay. Every last one of them.
Aye. The Whitehills need to answer for this. And Gwyn needs to answer for this. But we need to find out what she knows. She'll be over there. Be cautious, my lord. If she go around her father to help us, she must have some purpose.
She's taken a risk in meeting. Let me hear what she has to say before I judge her reasons.
Just be wary. You see what her family's done here.
Here. You might want this. You may have known each other since you were children, but this could be a trap.
Although she might be thinking the same thing.
Doesn't hurt to be careful.
Go on. I'll stay with the horses.
It's not enough to take our wood. They must defile our homes.
Damn Whitehills. Cutting down everything they see. Do they understand nothing about ironwood? Split beams, cracked wheels, shoddy workmanship. Clearly Whitehill. This well. I remember hiding down there, playing monsters and maidens with little Naaman and Megan. I can still smell the sawdust. Hear the whining of the grindstone. Such a part of my early years. So long ago.
I see you haven't lost your warrior's ways. That's good. I wouldn't want to deal with someone careless.
Hello, Gwyn.
Roderick. You saw my father's work over there, didn't you? There's no way to miss it.
And he won't stop. He means to do that to every inch of your land.
Soon, there will be nothing left to save. I hope you come with help, Gwyn.
And I hope you'll listen to me. I come as a friend. I wasn't sure you were even going to show. We're taking a risk, meeting like this. Unfortunately, it's the way it has to be.
Thank you for paying respects to my father and brother. And for coming tonight. It's good to see you again.
And you too, Roderick. I think we can help each other. But first, I've heard news of Asher. That he plans to return to Ironwrath. Why is he coming back? I loved him once. I longed for Asher to come back. But not like this.
How do you know about my brother?
That's part of why I'm here. But I need to know you've come for the same reasons I have. I want peace between our families. No more wars. No more bloodshed. Is that what you want too? I need to hear you say it, Roderick.
Yes. Peace means my family will be safe. Of course that's what I want.
The years have blessed you with wisdom, Roderick. And it is good you have it. Because peace is the only hope your family has. My father is just waiting for an excuse to attack. Why do you think he sent my brother? So there will be trouble. My father will bring utter ruin on your house. Unless you let Griff feel like he's in control. I know you refuse to kiss my father's ring, but you would be wise to show more respect to Griff.
I'm not afraid of some petulant fourthborn.
You should be, because there's a very dangerous fourthborn in your house right now.
My lord, a band of riders approach from the north.
Seven hells. My father's guards must be tracking me. If they catch us here, they'll kill you.
Then we've no time to waste. Let's get on with it.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. I don't know all the details, but he's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing. I fear for your family, Roderick.
You may think you've nothing more to lose. He is ready to show you otherwise.
What the hell is your father planning?
I swear I don't know, but whatever it is, he knows all your weaknesses, all your plans.
What? How?
Because you have a traitor in your council. Someone who knows every detail of your circumstances. My father boasts of it.
You must tell me. Who is it?
I don't know. We know you're planning to rescue Ryan. Even if it means abandoning your home to Griff.
What?
My father's guards are close. I need to know you'll do what I've asked. Promise me you'll submit to Griff. If you want peace between our families, it's the only way.
That all depends on how Griff carries himself.
You'll let my brother decide? Then clearly, you have given yourself over to slaughter. There's been enough killing. I hope you do your part.
My lord, those riders are nearly upon us. We have to go.
What I told you. Be careful what you do with it. And remember, I'll hear about it if you don't.
Lord?
Come along, Duncan. Mother.
Roderick. Look at what's become of our house. You were nowhere to be found, and they just... Oh, they are vile men. Where were you? We need you here. To hold this house together.
Mother, I went to see Gwyn Whitehill.
You did what? You would meet with the girl who once tore this house apart? Oh, I see now why you went in secret. Surely you must have known I would have counseled against it.
She wants to help us. She wants to bring about peace. And as much as you may mistrust her, we need help.
I don't know how you can trust that. Well, what did she have to say?
Lord Whitehill is plotting against us. I don't know his plans, but I fear them. And the only way he'll stop is if we submit to Griff's rule of our house.
What? Would you really give up control of our house? Griff is already a torment. How much worse could it get?
I have to keep the peace with Griff, even if that means letting him have his way at times.
The thought of it makes me ill.
I don't like it either.
Was this all? Did you learn anything more? You need to tell me.
What I've told you is nothing compared to what else I've learned. There is a traitor in our house, on our council.
No, this can't be. And all our plans to save Ryan, to save this house.
All gone.
Roderick, who could have turned on us? Times have been hard, but I never thought this would happen.
I have to say, Royland worries me the most.
Perhaps. But what about Duncan?
Duncan?
Or Maester Ortengren? If we don't know, then we can't trust anyone. Then again, I don't know why we should believe anything that girl told you. The Whitehills would love to sow dissent in our house with lies of traitors.
Get in there! Go on, get in there.
Get in there. Get in there. Oh, it's not like you. You do what you want, so.
Please, not like you. Just leave it over there. Fucking was.
No,
he was standing over there.
Get down there!
Get down there!
Get down there!
Hey, he's had enough. What do you want from me?
No, he was over there.
And Ramsay was here.
I'll play it how I want.
You will bend the knee to your liege lord.
Never! I don't kneel to bastards!
Yes, yes! That's so much more fun!
What is this? What are you bastards doing?
Oh, look here! It's the new lord! You're in luck. We're just getting to the best part. Little Lord Ethan's final breath. Unless you want to play the Lord of House Forrester instead.
You can't do this. You can't do this! Get out of our house! Right now!
We'll do as we please. Besides, we're not finished.
You must stop.
Oh, I know you've seen it before, but it gets better every time.
Show some respect in my house. In my home.
And that's what we're doing. Remembering young Ethan as he was.
Oh, please, no!
Say hello to your father.
Oh, no, Ethan!
He's down.
Oh, well done, well done. I'd say he died better than the real Ethan.
Better than the real Ethan.
What about you, eh? You want to be next?
Men without honor are lower than dogs.
I'd be happy to dirty my blade with your blood.
Before this is over, your blood will join my brother's on that floor. So I hope this was all worth it.
It'll be worth it when I pull this blade from your neck and see the life drain out your eyes.
Make his mother watch.
No more fucking
now we'll really have some fun.
Enough! Griff will deal with him. When he's done, he'll own this fucking house. And he'll have more than just words for you. Take your boy out of here while you still can.
Roderick! Roderick! Now is not the time.
Wendell, pack the extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry. Garrod.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor. They're hiding in the woods at a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers. The cowards murdered Commander Mormon. We're going to kill every one of them.
I'll volunteer to go.
I thank you for that. I need every sword I can get. But Britt's going too. He took his vows in the sept. He's a brother now. I understand why you hate him. But bad blood could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'm a ranger now. I've left my past behind me, Britt included.
Until you're standing next to him with a sword in your hand. That's the real test. If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrod. I'll be taking a chance.
I understand. You won't have any trouble from me.
I'll hold you to that. It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well, make sure they're ready.
Duff! Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much.
Definitely doesn't like you, Finn.
Haven't heard him singing your praises, any.
He wants to see us work together. No more problems.
That's on you.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with either of you on this Craster's mission.
Well, there's something you should know, then. I borrowed this from you.
What?
I just got curious. I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
I didn't mean no harm, honest. I just wanted a quick look. I wasn't stealing. Always planned on giving it back.
You can't keep doing that, Cotter. Next time, ask.
Well, I did try. And you just said your uncle was here about Ironwood. But I think it was something else. I noticed this part here.
North Grove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumour.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrod. You don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that. Didn't think you were that gullible.
Lord Forrester knew all about it. He said it's a place of great power. Power that could save my house.
And this says it's somewhere in the north. On the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrod. You two deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
He doesn't know about the mammoths. Or White Walkers. Or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
But you know, it's the things you hear about. The rumours is all. I wouldn't know myself. How could I?
Rumours my ass. You're hiding something, Cotter.
I'm not. Just things I hear around Castle Blacksall. People talk, you know.
Not about the North Grove, they don't.
You do? Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits. I don't know. What does it matter? It was nothing.
Cotter, I know you're lying. This is why it's so hard to be your friend.
All right. All right.
I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. You see, I live there, in the north. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings. I know it's crazy.
I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons, south of the wall. We got caught, so I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing.
I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place. I didn't know what else to do.
Porter, you're the bloody enemy. How am I supposed to trust you now?
I'm not your enemy, Garrett. I'm your friend. Or at least I thought I was. Are we still friends? I mean, I know it's a lot to take in, and I'd understand if you were angry.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cutter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking!
I'll be right there.
I'm going back home, no matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No. But I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway, heading back home. I can guide you, keep you alive.
Stick with me and I'll show you the way. Plenty of things out there want to kill you. Others want to eat you.
All right. Even if you are a bloodthirsty wildling.
I won't let you down.
Cutter! Now!
On the way!
Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere.
Yeah.
You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No. No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher, I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
I fought beside you, Uncle, too many times to count. I figured you could handle yourself. Beskar was the one face to face with a dragon.
I appreciate the respect, but it's not about that. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother. Sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'll be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are gonna stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you. To protect you.
I understand and I know what's important. My family comes first.
That's good to hear. But words are wind, Asher. It's choices that define who we are.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are.
Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester! Son of a poxy whore! You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
You get it out your system?
Not by half. You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you. Not a fucking chance. So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable!
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose!
Look, Croft, what we did was wrong. I'm sorry for that.
You heard him, now let him go!
You're not getting out of this with a fucking apology!
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beska. You're next. Now choose! Or I slice off your balls, Asher!
Hey!
A man betrays my trust. There's a price to be paid.
Let him go!
Enough!
No more fucking about!
Fuck you, Croft!
Have it your way. You didn't need your testicles anyway.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass.
Are you fucking joking?
You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interesting sense of humor.
So what in seven hells are you two doing here on the arse end of the earth, eh? You're a long way from, young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We? You're hardly the usual rabble these two travel with.
We need an army, Croft. My home back in Westeros is under siege.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tip? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her grace pays good coin.
I've got wine, women, I've got my own tent, and it never fucking snows.
Did this Khaleesi make you a house cat, Croft? Curled up at her feet? Since when do you turn down an adventure?
Since the second son swore to Daenerys bloody Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet, Asher.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on posts for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Ha! Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you've just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world?
Black scales all over with a red frill running down his back.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft, I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this, it'll cost more than your balls.
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. You'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Big day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do. But if it was real, can you trust Potter with it? You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean. Like he's holding something back.
Potter's not a bad sort. I trust him.
Even after he tried stealing your map? Do as you like. But if we're going out there tomorrow, in the middle of fucking nowhere, I'd want to know who I can trust.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right.
Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
This one's still good. I need to light this torch. Uncle Duncan brought these from Ironwrath. Wonder if I'll ever see it again. That's ironwood for sure. If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them. Solid ice. This won't be melting anytime soon. This must hold up the lift. Probably fall apart if it wasn't frozen together.
Pig farmer. A 300-mile walk. And you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Crasters. But this is even better. Jon Snow can't hold your hand now.
I don't have any time for you anymore, Bren. I hate you. You hate me. Now let's move on.
Had something more painful in mind. I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. And for doing a proper job of it, what I get? Banished to the fucking wall! I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone. So I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got. Shrieking the whole time.
You're not worth it.
I didn't come to attack you, fucking cunt. Too bad your father didn't fight like that. I'd still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy. Finally getting the hang of it, Tuttle.
Stop, damn it! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like you're...
You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me. Like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
I swore my vows. I won't kill a brother.
You're fucking pathetic, Tuttle.
Whoa!
fucking finish it. Go on.
We're done here.
My lord, our people are starving and afraid. The White Hills have driven them away from the ironwood groves.
Out of the way!
To make matters worse, your brother Ethan had me collect provisions from the small folk. And so they come to us, looking for food. Food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and retain our position in the north? We can't even feed the people we see before us. It's like the dead of winter's come. And it doesn't look like it's getting better.
No one has more fight in them than Asher. I'm sure he and Malcolm will find us the army we need.
Well, I hope we can figure something out. As long as the White Hills are in our house, we have to be careful.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this. Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me.
I don't care if she's your sister.
He deserved it.
She bit your man. How did that happen? What did he do to her? That doesn't matter. It matters what she did.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
Thieves have to be punished, so your man got what he deserved. He's lucky he didn't get any worse than that.
So you've given over your duties to this girl, then? Or can you not control your sister?
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, yeah, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline. They've all been missing that.
You can shout and preen all you like, but it's just for show. You do as your father Lud wishes.
And even he knows that punishing girls was never part of the deal with Ramsay Snow.
And how would you know? Eh? It was poor little Ethan who dealt with the Boltons. Oh, this house is rotten. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Careful, boy.
You yourself had the gall to make threats against my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough to look down at you.
Wait. Forgive her. Forgive her. The passions of youth. No one questions your authority, Griff. You have the power.
Oh, I like him. You thought this was your man, Roderick? He's mine. A dog to be sure, but my dog. That's how I like to see you, foresters. Obedient servants!
He's a loyal member of my house. A man of peace. And he deserves to be treated as such.
You don't get it, do you? You foresters need to learn when you're beaten.
You will learn some fucking humility.
Or this won't be the last lesson I teach you, foresters!
Have you no honour? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
I'm fine, Roiland. I'm fine. I'll handle this.
Even broken, he's twice the man you are.
I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Roderick!
I will not yield.
You bloody snot. Why don't you fucking get it?
Get up, Roderick.
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother Ethan didn't know his place either. Ramsay Snow taught him good. Talia here will meet the same end. Unless you're a good little forester, you learn your place and stay down.
Some forester is going to learn their lesson today.
You don't have to do that, Lord Griff.
Will it be you? Or will it be...
Don't you dare! You stay down! Stay in the mud like a dog! This is my place! You fool!
Oh, Lord!
What?! Bloody cripple! Are you fucking deaf?!
You! You'll never keep the foresters down!
Hold there, or you're next!
Please, Lord Griff, not the arm! If you persist, Lord Roderick may lose it!
Now, stay down.
Tell me!
Will you be a good little forester?
My lord, please, just do it. Down. Stay down.
Don't be a fool.
He's had enough.
I decide when he's had enough.
Good. Consider this even, girl. Your brother learned the lesson for you. You'd be wise to follow his lead.
As would all of you. Your lord is a smart man. First in his line that understands. Now you need to understand too. You can be lord, Roderick. So long as we all know who holds the reins here. Come on.
You did the right thing, my son. You had to submit.
Aye. A true lord.
But we let them win. Do you see that? He still acts like he rules the house. But he's let his guard down. So, did he get what he wanted? Or did you? At the time, I wanted you to crush him. I'm just glad you're still alive. We need you, Roderick.
Now is not the time to fight. But that time is coming. And if Griff thinks he's won... He won't be ready when it does.
And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. He promised he wouldn't, and look what happened. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
That's good. I'm sure a time will come when our house will call upon you to do what's necessary. But that time is not now.
And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. what you did. Yielding to Griff, you had your reasons. But...
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, foresters will stand tall.
We did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for? What? After everything, we just...
I can't burn it.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons... choose your words carefully.
What have you done, Garrett? Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira, what are you doing?
Mira, just tell me what's going on. What are you hiding from me?
We are weak. We have no allies. And Griff claims to be the new Lord of Ironwrath.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to Highpoint.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your queen.
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asher.
Garrett. It's time to go.